Why do we have a spine? It's because our bodies must protect the signals from your head to your body parts. Your brain sends communication to your muscles and structures. The connecting signals to those parts are through the extension of the brain, which is a spinal cord. Then coming off the spinal cord are individual nerves that go to the individual muscles, individual organs, and individual areas of skin sensation. The best analogy I can give is that of the light switch. Specific light switches go to specific lamps in the room. One light switch may go to the lamp in the kitchen. One light switch may go to the lamp in the front of the house. Each of these individual wires are like the nerves that go from the brain to a certain part of your body. The bundle of all the individual wires that come out of the brain is the spinal cord. They then separate to become those individual wires to the specific areas. The brain and the extension of the brain, the spinal cord, and the individual nerves are easily damaged. That is why the brain is encased in a very hard bone called your skull. Very protective, that bone. In addition, the extension of the brain, the spinal cord, is protected by a bone of the spine called a vertebrae. But these protective bones, the skull and the vertebrae, need to also move. That's why the spine is more than just bones encasing the spinal cord and nerves. It also is composed of a softer component called the disc. Now the disc has two main parts. The strong outer part is called the annulus fibrosus, and it acts as a ligament holding the bones to each other. This allows the bone and the spine to bend and turn and rotate without breaking or dislocate. The softer inner piece is called the nucleus puposus, and it acts as a shock absorber and also creates a disc space between the bones, allowing the nerves to branch off from the spinal cord into the respective body parts. The combination of the bone and the disc protects the spinal cord and the nerves while still allowing controlled movement. That is why we need a spine. I hope this makes it easier for you to understand why we have a spine and why we need a spine. Thank you for listening. If you'd like more information about similar topics, please subscribe to our newsletter or our YouTube channel.